Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. As we all know that the whole world is dependent on internet for functioning. Even today, we are going to do this presentation on YouTube rather than a regular class. I, Tithara Shah, along with my friend Harsh Kumar Agarwal from Team Rohini, will discuss about InfoEdge and internet industry. If this pandemic, we can afford to do work from home for this internet. Sanjeev Bikhchandani was the founder of InfoEdge. Was incorporated on May 1, 1995 under Section Companies Act 1956 as InfoEdge India Private Limited and become a listed company on April 27, 2006, starting with online classified as Naukri.com, it has grown rapidly and it diversified its portfolio. Online recruitment classified Naukri is a clear market leader in Indian e-recruitment services. A specially focused on Middle East market, Naukri Gulf is also an important service provided by Naukri. Jeevansathi.com, online matrimonial website, among the top three matrimonial website in India. Online real estate classified 99acres.com, India's largest property marketplace. They also provide education classified Siksha.com. They have done various investment in technology-based startup such as Zomato, which is an online delivery business where their shareholding is 26.4%. They have done investment in Ustra, which is a men grooming platform. Their shareholding is 41.1%. They have also done investment in PolicyBazaar.com, where their shareholding is 15.8%, which is an online policy market. They have also done investment in MeritNation.com, where their shareholding is 65.6%. The further discussion will be carried over by my teammate Harsh Kumar Agarwal.
Now we are going to look upon the current state of the InfoEdge company. Their report of financial year 2019 has been reported an increasing of revenue by 19.9996% in the fiscal, as which we have learned that, and there has been increase in the billing point of the billing operating income, which has been by 20.51% to be precise enough. After that, we are going to about learn, we have taken the analysis and come up to the knowledge that we have the total income of InfoEdge analysis is 19.56% and the operating revenue of EBITDA has been come at 14.82%. Now we are going to look upon the pre-COVID part and post-COVID part of the InfoEdge analysis. The pre-COVID part shows a 13% growth in the pre-COVID session, and in March analysis we have taken the analysis. Now when the lockdown begins, the growth of the InfoEdge analysis has been slowed down as it has been impacted the industry. Many people has declined to take new employees, which affect the market of the InfoEdge analysis as they are dealing with many of the like job portal, marriage portal, and property portal, real estate portal, many more things, which has been given a tremendous effect in the growth of the InfoEdge analysis, as job portal and the real estate portal has been the biggest growth, biggest revenue generation business of the InfoEdge analysis. Though there is a slowdown in the marriage portal, but it's okay. It's not generating much revenue in the fiscal year. as they it's affect the market, but at the end it does not affect that much like the job portal naukri.com and the real estate portal 99acres.com has been affecting the fiscal, affecting the profit of and the growth of the info journalists. But it the growth has been slowed down in this 3 to 4 months, but it has been seen a growing aspect in the long term basis, as now people are shifting from physical world to a digital world. All things has been shifted to a digital world. People are giving their resume through online satellites. They cannot go and contact to the company in the physical way, and the all interviewing part, selection process, and each and every recruiting process has been done in the interview process. All has been done in a digital way, which has been be a great opportunity for the InfoEdge space, InfoEdge people, and InfoEdge the company. And analysis have seen a growth in the second half year of the InfoEdge company. After seeing the pre-COVID part and post-COVID part of InfoEdge company, now we are looking at the competitor of InfoEdge. Who are the competitor? First competitor is iamjobs.com, second competitor justdial.com, third competitor infiavenue.com, fourth competitor matrimonial.com, fifth competitor that is linkedin. These are the competitor of InfoEdge analysis, which somehow they compete the InfoEdge in, like InfoEdge is having many business in that process, they are competing this with InfoEdge analysis. Now market, we are looking about the market capitalization of InfoEdge analysis. First we have to look upon what is in market capitalization. Market capitalization is the capital amount, market is the certain amount of price which the company is going to post up in the market for the sell of their shares. It has been calculated through multiplying the price of the stock into total number of outstanding stock. This is the simple formula of market capitalization. Now we are looking how much market capital the InfoEdge analysis, like the amount of rupees which the stock price which the InfoEdge analysis and its competitor have. InfoEdge analysis has the 2,730 rupees as the current rate. Second, the Infibeam Avenue has 57 rupees market capitalization. JustDial.com has 378.45 rupees and Matrimony.com has 367.50 market and market share capitalization in the stock market, in the market and the shares which they are going to sell up in the market. Now our next topic is the Gartner Magic Quadrant. It is a cumulative of the research in a specific market, giving you a wide angle view of relative positions of the market competitor. Gartner ranks vendor into a magic quadrant based on their ability to execute and the competitiveness of their vision, placing them into 4 categories. First category, niche player. Second category, visionaries. Third category, challengers. Fourth category, leaders. First, niche player. Niche player are those who have low vision and low execution. Visionaries, who have good vision but low execution. Challengers, good execution but low vision. Leaders, who will excel in both execution and vision. InfoEdge has not got any position in the Gartner quadrant, and we don't have any information that they are qualifying for it or not. But according to the structure that we will probably assume that it will qualify the leader position, as it has excelled in its vision and as well as in the execution part. Now I would like So thank you, our Professor Chandrakant sir, for giving this opportunity to do this presentation, and thank you to the viewer for watching this video. Thank you.